If you are not the change, we will become the change. If you are not standing up, why shout anybody else? Be the change you want to see. Be the change you want to make in this world. Be the light. Be the truth. Be the inspiration you're searching for. Become the hero. If you're living in a world without heroes, become one hero. You can do it. You'll have to believe in yourself to change the world for the better. We have to stop wishing for some hero to change this world for us. And we have to start. Be the inspiration where others are searching for. We must change. The animals don't want to be turned into a commodity for our entertainment. The animals on this world don't want to be food, just like women don't want to be sex toys for disgusting perfect men. That something shows you are accepted by a society does not mean it is right, justice, or whatever. A threat to justice everywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Sometimes anybody is wrong. In the time of slavery, the majority of the people were wrong when it comes about slavery of blacks and sometimes of whites who are poor. Have a better look. Let me not forget in America that in the beginning, according to the institution, only white, European, land-owning, slave-owning men can vote and have any rights as a citizen in the society. Blacks, women, homosexuals, and many more were conveniently excused from being considered one citizen of the society in America, for example. In the time of the Middle Ages, in the Europe world, only elite people, rich people, kings, queens, heralds, lords, princes and princesses, and this kind of people had rights, can walk free. Specific the male versions of the people we are talking about. Sometimes if you are a princess, you have to marry some creeper old man in the middle age, but the man have all the rights in America and in the West in that time. The world of the West is built by man, and therefore it favors man. And if you are not convinced that there is something as sexism in your society, why does it be an insult to call a group of men, specifically athletes, women, girls, queers, or homosexuals? If there is no sexist ideology in that. Think a little bit about it. If speciesism was not a thing, why we use animal names as insults? Why we call somebody we don't like a pig?
And by the way, look at the horrible things we do to pig ears. We notch them, it's called ear notching, to mark them. These are all rescued pigs, by the way, from the meat industry. Look at the horrible things we do to their ears. Look at that. How dare we mutilate living beings? One of the lucky ones.
Pigs are beautiful, perfect creatures.
They happy as a pig in shit. That's an absolute lie. Pigs actually despise shit. That barn that we were just in, the barn where they like to sleep, they never poop in their own barn. They're actually one of the cleanest animals of all the farm animals. Pigs are happy in mud, but not shit. This is mud, and this is done to protect their sensitive skin from the sun.
They're nice, friendly, they are reddened, they like to get belly ropes, that's just like dogs.
What's up, buddy? What's up, buddy? What's up? And they got the wet noses? Yes, they do. Yes, they do. And, Erica, let's see if we can get a...
Let's give it a whirl.
A pig to go down for a belly rope.
That's the best.
Oh, boy. Oh, they love a belly rope.
They have their own personalities. So, stop thinking that animals don't matter just because they don't act like you do, or exactly like your dog do. Stop being a bigot. Stop discriminating based on arbitrary criteria like skin color, the amount of hair, or to which kind of species you belong. That are all arbitrary, unreasonable criteria of moral environment. If we say that somebody is smart, since that people are smarter than other animals, it is okay to kill them. Then we can say that scientists have the right to kidnap anybody, since their IQ is at least 20 to 40% higher. Than that of the average population, so they are superior. And sometimes scientists have an IQ for over the 200. And therefore, according to your own logic, they have the right to kidnap you and use you in scientific experiments, since you think the amount of intelligence is a great reason for the consideration of moral violence. There are also a lot of many stupid reasons, but let me just be clear. Nobody in the 21st century needs to hunt or kill animals in other way for food. The animals that are not willing participants in any, even a little bit on the slaughterhouse work, I can tell you that. They try to escape from that psychos because they will know what comes next. And they don't want to die. Peace begins on a dinner table, by what you eat on a daily basis. And if we are so superior, why do we then constantly exploit each other? Constantly exploit other animals for things we don't need. Sounds to me like barbaric savage behavior. Sounds to me like an uncivilized cult. Some of you like that Playo people and that guy, what's his name? Oh yes, Uncle John Reagan. Veganism is not a cult. Your society is a cult. A big, creepy, weird cult. A cult how murder any year 70 billion land animals and 2.8 trillion marine animals. For nothing more than taste pleasure. Be careful for throwing stones in somebody's glass house, people. We vegans are not the extreme once how murder innocence for taste pleasure. That are you. Have you the courage to look yourself in the eye? Look yourself in the mirror and admit when you are wrong. Apologize for the way you have living, evolve and go vegan. Eat beans, eat lentils, eat legumes. Eat bananas, eat cakey fruits. Eat durians, eat mangoes. But let the animals alone. They are not willing participants. If you are not the victim, don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Because if you are not the victim, it becomes pretty easy to mock your victims, make fun of their entire existence, label them stupid and dirty, like Adolf Hitler, like Hammond, the governor of the South, like Gaddafi, and many more have done to the Pacific victims. And please stop saying that Hitler is vegetarian or vegan. That's the most biggest arbitrary shit of the whole world. Hitler was not vegetarian nor vegan. He wasn't meat eater. And his most favorite food was liver dumplings. Like German chef Dionne Lugas have said in her gourmet cooking book. So as always, go vegan. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinter away and the true become visible.